Welcome back. Well, AU Small Finance Bank is in focus on account of its Q3 numbers. We have Sanjay Agarwal, the MD and CEO of the company, to discuss their quarterly performance. Mr. Agarwal, hi. Thanks very much for joining in. Let's start with a couple of parameters such as asset quality. That's improved this quarter to 2.83 versus 3.08%. Tell us about what happened this quarter and the expectation going forward.
No, I think overall our quarter performance is at par, you know, whatever we estimated over the year, right? It's a 9-month performance. Our asset has grown by, you know, 38%. Our disbursement has grown by 45%. Our profit is largely unchanged from year on year, in spite of our year transition to bank. And, you know, asset, as I last time also told you, that economy is getting settled down. You know, there's a lot of vibrancy is available in the market. A lot of business has been settled down, so our NPA has come down and is around 2.8 in comparison to 3.1 last quarter.
So across the main business segments, be it vehicle loans, MSME, SME, could you give us some color and any pressure points in each of these three areas?
So I'll say that, you know, the whole pressure point around economy has gone down. Honestly, you know, the GST has settled down, there's no effect of demonetization, and last two quarter we have seen quite amount of traction around commercial vehicle sale, personal vehicle sale, and there is enough money available with the customer, right? So I think that's why the NPA also has come down. So I don't think any much of the pain areas here and there, smaller here and there, but largely we believe that this story will continue, and we are all expecting this and, you know, maybe next year to be more robust in terms of our infra spending, in terms of our commercial vehicle requirement, the MSME and SMEs.
So you expect this kind of disbursement growth that you're seeing and asset under management growth that you've seen for the first 9 months to continue into FY19 as well?
So I think this is a position which we have maintained, I think, from last 1.5 years, that because of our base and because we have become bank, you know, there is a lot of pull which is available in the market for us. And we believe that our MSME and our vehicle segment should grow in the range of 30% to 40%, or maybe 35% to 40% range. And that is being continued from last three quarter. And I believe that next 3 to 4 quarter will also be like this.
What is the dependence in terms of funds that you raised from your wholesale dependent, and it was expected to come down gradually? Could you just talk about that?
Yeah, so our treasury is well balanced. You know, we have already raised around 3,700 crores from deposits, and out of which around 35% is our CASA. So I think our retail liability is shaping up well. We already have around 300 branches across 10-12 states. So we are believing, I think there is a little bit of pressure on the interest rates as we move forward, but largely money is available in this small pocket. And I believe that as we move forward, you know, our RS franchise will be more visible, franchise will get settled down in terms of our process, product and IT. I think there will be good traction around our deposit base also.
Okay. All right. Fair enough, Mr. Agarwal. We're going to leave it on that note. Thanks very much for joining in and speaking with us. So that is the management of AU Small Finance Bank. That stock is down around 3.6%, but it's in line with a lot of the broader market stocks falling. Like I've been pointing out, HDFC Standard Life, Syngene, which is down around 3.8%, not much in terms of volumes, but nonetheless, Jubilant Foodworks as well, that stock down 3%, and TVS Motors, that stock has corrected around 3-odd% today as well. Take a break, but more on the markets once we're back. Stay tuned.